Good morning. Well, my husband made few more purchases earlier this morning, and I'd like to show you what we purchased to be sure that we have food up to April. So we spent, for this time he spent $20, I would say $19.59 on, let me just show you here on, cheese, sugar, tomato puree, and that's 29 cents a pound. I like to use it for sourdough pizza. I'm going to show you, rising one right now for sourdough pizza. So I will make tomato pizza sauce using these. And we have sugar here, that's 10 pounds. It doesn't cost much, and it's cheaper than buying smaller quantities. But each time you buy bigger quantities, you might want to do the calculation or pay attention to the price per ounce or per unit, because it's not always the case that the bigger size is cheaper. We have 2 pounds of cheese. So it's cheaper for us to buy this size than the smaller size, even when I compared to the price Aldi charges for it, it's cheaper to buy this from Walmart. And I like mozzarella cheese because it has few ingredients. So, and I showed you before, pasteurized milk, cultured salt, and enzymes. So that's all it is in it. I don't know why, but I like my food to have as, you know, to have just few ingredients as possible. That's why I like this tomato, canned tomato. I don't buy paste tomato any longer, because paste tomato has citric acid in it to keep it, you know, to make it sour enough, you know, to avoid some bacteria in it, So I believe for tomato paste, they use Roma, and I think Roma is not high in acid enough for that. So this one will say tomato pulp. So nothing else. So that's why I like to get it. It's quite sour, but yeah. And that's 29 ounces. He finally got some elbow macaronis here, 3 pounds. I was looking for 5 pound bags, but they were out, so he got some of those. And I think that's pretty much it. We are set for the can. He got 5, but he got one yesterday, a dented one. So that's pretty much what he spent money on this time, and purchased pay about $19.59. so far I have my spreadsheet open here, but so far we spent for April, we spent $127.10 for April purchases. And we spent an additional $31.50 to purchase few items for March. And that came from March food budget. So what we spent an extra is $127.20 to purchase items for April. So in March, we spent so far $329.04 for March and April purchases. So yeah, so that's that. So I'm keeping track of that to see how much really I'm spending so far for April, and when we wanted to take money out for April, we will take that out of it. We already took money out for April, but I'm putting those purchases on my credit card, and then I'll pay it off using the checking account, and I wanted to have some cash on hand. So we took some cash out for our purchases, and I'm keeping track of those purchases so that I'm sure I have an idea how much exactly we spend on groceries that will go under April. So that's what I wanted to show you here. Now let me show you. Yesterday we purchased some bread, and I bought them, put them in the freezer. I'm going to show that, and I'm rising dough for pizza. I will show you that as well. And we spend we purchased flowers. I'm going to show you why I purchased those items that we purchased, what I do with them. I made some meal yesterday, egg roll, which we call wraps at home, and chicken soup and cornmeal. So I'm going to show you those items, and I will have the description. In the description, I will have the price, how much it cost me to make them. I think the soup, the cornmeal, the chicken soup and the cornmeal cost me about 46 cents a person, or $3 something for the whole dinner, and we have leftovers. And the egg roll costs us about $6 something, a little bit less than $7 for 7 people, 4 adults, 3 kids, and that's about 97 cents a person for lunch. So to give you an idea why I purchased those items that I purchased, even though that's an emergency, I'm not purchasing anything differently that we don't use. You know, I'm just stocking up on staples. Yes, you can build your food budget, you can build your food supply on budget if you purchase staples, raw staples, to cook from scratch rather than buying packaged food. They are a little bit pricier, but once again, you need to buy what you use. It doesn't make sense to buy something that you don't use on a regular basis. It may not be the right time to try new things, you know. So you might just focus on having a list of things you wanted to buy. If you want to build your food supply on budget and you are on a low budget, you might want to have a list of your groceries and stick to the list and purchase items that you use on a daily basis. And I'm going to have a video on things that you should be spending money on if you are on low budget. But let me show you what the bread and then the sourdough pizza that I'm making and those dishes that I made yesterday that cost me less than $1 a person per meal. And I'll have the description. The description of those dishes in the description of the video for you to take a look at, and I'll have it on my website as well. So let's go take a look at this. We'll make the first stop at the freezer section. I'd like to do that. And that's my two freezers here. And I strongly recommend, if you want to build a food supply, to have freezers for your freezer staples. I don't put vegetables in my fridge. They go in the freezer. So you see those breads that we purchased yesterday. I have butter. I don't know if I get to find butter here very quickly. But I have butter on sale not too long ago, and my husband stock up on that. I believe it was about $1.68. So that's butter. And I video some purchases for March that are like the first week of March, but I'm not sure I posted it yet. I'm going to post that as well. You can see the ingredients. That's just few ingredients here: pasteurized cream and salt. So I like this better than the sweetened one. So, and I use that's the leftover
here. So I used them from my garden, which I kept in the freezer. Just pound it, add the butter to it, mix it up. And I used three blocks. So that's three quarter of a pound. That's what I put in those four breads. In fact, I should have put the cost breakdown in the description of the video. I'll see if I remember, I'll do that. So the bread costs us 75 cents and the butter $1.60. We use three quarter of that. The herb is free from the garden, and that's the bread. So you'll see how I cut it and just butter it and put it back in the bag. So if I don't have time to make cornmeal, cornbread, or bread, you know, I have them here. So let's move on. Oh, and I can show you the soup that I made yesterday. I used creeping Charlie and dandelion. Don't know if I have leftovers of those. Okay, I can show you here. Don't know if you get to see it. Creeping Charlie. So that's that. And I just put in the harvest and wash it, chop it up, and I put it here. And that's my vegetables freezer here. Now let's move up. I need to get oil out of here. And I will spread my sourdough in the pan to let it rise the second time. Darling, can you turn the TV down, please? Thank you. And as you can see here, wow, I need to do something about this. That's my sourdough. That's 7 cups of flour. You can see how it rises. It rolls all the way to the top. So I'm going to use my cast iron. I will use this one as well. And I will use this one. So this one will cover this, and I'll put a plastic around this one. I will use this glass to cover this, and I'll just let them here to rise for hours. And I can show you what time it is. It's early in the morning. I've been up for some hours now. You can see how dark it is outside. And I can see it. Oh, not. I'm the one looking there, but yeah. So that will be able to rise by 10. Or 11 in the morning, I will start putting it in the oven, so that will have some hours to rise again, and that will look more like a double, like a deep dish pizza. So now let's look at what we made. And the reason why I like to buy the sugar is because I make porridge using wheat. Whole wheat berries. So that's the remaining of last week porridge here. So when I cook that for the kids and myself, I like to have sugar on hand. And I believe I have shown that before. Maybe it has been in the video that I have not published yet, but I have it here. I can just show you this here. And you see it. And I purchased it in 2016 that I opened this box, and it's still in good shape. So I make porridge out of that, and I like to have sugar on hand. So Let me turn this light on here. And probably put the camera down so that I don't swing it too much. Let's get more out. So we have the wrap here, the soup here as well. And I think that's, oh, sorry. That's pretty much it. I have leftover of tomato pizza sauce here that I put in the freezer. Now I took it out last night, and that's what I'm going to use for the pizza. I'll take 2 pounds of meat out of the freezer, and that will thaw as well, and I'll cook that for the pizza. So yesterday I showed you the apples that were in bags, so you're able to take them out of the bags, and that's the first crisper. And that's our second crisper here. So that's that. Now let's take a look at our dishes. That's the sourdough. That's the cornmeal. That's the leftover. I didn't eat it. My husband didn't eat it either. So 2 adults and 3 kids ate it last night. That's the soup. And that has dandelion, creeping chilies, and onion from the garden. Chicken, broth, and salt. That's pretty much it. And this is the corn, the egg roll. An adult can eat it about 6 to be full, and kids can eat from 2 to 4 maximum. And that's that. That's what I use the flour for, and I like to have flour on hand. And this one I use flour, and I use cornmeal and sugar and milk. But sometimes I have made it before, when I switched milk to broth, homemade broth, it works as well. The taste was just a little bit different, but it works. So I can make it with broth if I don't have milk on hand. And this one is just flour and water for the dough, and sometimes salt, but I didn't even add salt to the dough. And then the inside is vegetables, which include onion and dandelion. No, yeah, onion, dandelion, and sorrel, I believe, and some and ground beef. And that's that for lunch. I fry in leftover milk, no, I fry in leftover peanut oil very quickly and put it in the oven to finish it up in the oven. So I didn't really use fresh peanut oil for it at all, other than to add it to the meat that I cook. So I use very little, few tablespoons of peanut oil to cook the meat, to brown the meat. That's pretty much it. And I use leftover oil to quick fry the egg roll, and then I just put them in a cast iron pan and put in the oven for 350 for about 40 minutes, and they were ready. So you can see we have a lot of leftovers here for it. After 7 people ate, and my husband took some to work as well. So I'm just going to put, and you can see that's a lot of leftovers here as well for the corn meat, for the corn bread. And there is something I didn't include in the course, is the ketchup. My kids like to use ketchup, so maybe I should include about a few cents for that as well. But I like to eat it without just with her opinion. So that's pretty much what I wanted to show you. And I'm going to just divide this in three with this cast iron having the most. I'll divide it probably, in now equal size, probably in four, with those two splitting the fourth one, and this one will have just one of the four. So I'll just do that, spread it all in it. I'll put all in it first. I'll wash my hand, put all in them, and then I'll walk in this, cover them, put them away to rise. I just let it rise here. I don't do anything special, but because we live in a, it's kind of dry around here, I cover this with towel to keep the flour moist. So I'll just do that and I'll let it rise here. I'll take some meat out, and that will be our lunch. And I had to think about what I'll make for dinner. Thank you for watching. I'm Afiavi Ojune, Liberman, creators of Liberman Consulting, L.L.C YouTube channel, and owners of Nina Soap. And our website is ninasoap.com.